sudden change of events. A woman accused of murder pleads guilty without admitting she committed a crime. We've been telling you about the allegations and suspicions surrounding Pam Hupp for the last 6 years. This afternoon in the St. Charles County courtroom, she took a plea deal that spared her from the death penalty. News 11's Chris Hayes was in the courtroom. He joins us live with more on what happened today. Chris?
Mike, it appeared Pam Hupp did not want to say the word guilty, only at first acknowledging to the judge, yes, in a special plea deal that avoids the death penalty. Then she said it, guilty, in this deal called an Alford plea, which means she's only saying she acknowledges prosecutors could prove the case against her, and she'll spend the rest of her life in prison. O'Fallon, Missouri police arrested Hupp for this crime almost 3 years ago. It was August 2016, and we captured the arrest exclusively. Hupp claims she shot Lewis Gumpenberger, a man with disabilities, in self-defense. But the story unraveled during the major case squad investigation. Hupp maintained her innocence until today. St. Charles County Prosecutor Tim Lomar talked about Hupp's plea deal.
I can't speak for them, but I will say it doesn't surprise me the least bit. And my opinion from day one was that this was going to go all the way through jury trial. And we may never hear her accept any responsibility on this. What you heard today in court was as close as you're ever going to get, I think, to hearing her take any responsibility for what she did.
Hupp hesitated for so long to say the word guilty. I counted 6 seconds. I later asked Prosecutor Lomar what was going through his mind. He said that the whole deal could blow up. But then she did acknowledge the evidence was overwhelming. County prosecutors say Hupp wanted to escape scrutiny surrounding the unsolved murder of her friend, Betsy Faria. They say she plotted the murder of a random person, and she planned to frame Russ Faria, Betsy's husband. August 2016, Hupp lured Lewis Gumpenberger with a fake story that she was a Dateline television producer and needed him to help with a 911 segment. She paid Gumpenberger $900 cash. Investigators linked to Hupp through the numbers on the bills. Instead of going to a taping, she took him to her house and she shot him to death inside her home. At the news conference immediately following Hupp's guilty plea, St. Charles County Prosecutor Tim Lomar played the haunting 911 call made in the seconds before Hupp shot Gumpenberger.
911, what's your emergency? Hey, hello, there's someone broken in my house. Help!
What's the address you're at?
Help!
Woman, did he do you? Woman, did he do your wife?
No, I'm not getting in the car with you. No,
get away. I'm
sorry. Get out, get out, get out.
Prosecutors stopped that 911 tape before the sound of gunshots out of respect for the victim's family. That thumping you heard was a banging on the door that she allegedly had Gumpenberger do during the call. Gumpenberger's mom, Margaret Birch, was there, said she didn't want to say much. She was devastated, said she was sick to her stomach. Today's plea closes one chapter on a twisting story we began investigating before anyone else even picked up on it.
Only Fox 2 has reported on events surrounding Pam Hupp from the time her friend was found murdered.
Lincoln County 911.
December 2011. Betsy Faria was stabbed to death in her Lincoln County home. We were the only station to cover the 2013 trial in which a jury convicted the husband, Russ Faria. We reported on the evidence kept from the jury, such as Faria's life insurance proceeds, signed into Hupp's name days before the murder. Our coverage led to a new trial in 2015. A judge found Russ Faria not guilty while raising questions about Pam Hupp's possible involvement. We continued our reporting, including investigating the bizarre death of Hupp's mom, her unexplained fall through the railings of a third-floor balcony, and her life insurance proceeds.
Prosecutors here in St. Charles County could only focus on the Gumpenberger killing because that's the only one that occurred here in St. Charles County. Pam Hupp's mom died in St. Louis County. Her friend Betsy Faria was murdered in Lincoln County.